location, let's focus on communicating, cause I just need the time and place to come through.
Morning guys, so this is my first morning in Milan. I got to Milan last night, so I have a couple of shows to go today. My first time in Milan fashion, so it's very exciting. I'm actually staying in a quite nice hotel. It's like quite cheap, quite nice, so I'm quite impressed. It's called the Monkiba Hotel, right in the center, so quite handy because my shows are just like in walking distance. But yeah, this is gonna be, I don't know what I'm gonna do with my hair, because if you follow me on Instagram you will know that I have just had an operation on my hand. I feel like Ross from Friends, you know, when he's got like the broken thumb. Long story, but I'm just accident prone. I literally am my own worst enemy. I cause so many, inflict so many accidents on myself. It's gonna be really good, my first time in Milan Fashion Week, so it should be really interesting. I can't wait to like compare it to London. Yeah, so I got here last night, just woken up. I've got my first show at 12, so yeah, welcome to my Milan Fashion Week vlog. If you saw my London Fashion Week vlog, you will know I had breakfast with Maybelline, and I just have a few of their products on. I need to do my nails, open my nails. They also have mascara all over them. Lovely. I have this on my lips, Superstay Matte Ink on my lips. If you'd have seen my last few vlogs, especially in LA, my skin broke out so bad. Like, I don't even know what happened. Like, I think it was after I started using a new foundation. I think my skin just did not like it. Like, I don't have the best skin anyway, but I think this foundation just made it like, oh god, it was horrendous. Like, in LA, I've never seen anything like it, but it seems to have cleared up. Like, I've obviously got scars still, and like, it's all going down, but like, no new spots, no new spots, which is ironic because I've just had a really busy month, and now that we're coming to the end of it, it's a bit annoying, but I'm very happy not to have any spots. I've got to make this look attractive, surely. This is going to be interesting. I'm not too sure what to do with it because I can't like put it in a bun or anything, and I find it really hard to curl it with one hand. I don't know what we're going to do. We'll see. You know me guys, I obviously like bulldozed the hotel room in a matter of seconds. I am like the clumsiest, messiest person going. A large factor in why I'm single, probably. Anyway, I have on a full check, head to toe check, and I have a leather scrunchie in my hair because of, I thought I'd go back to the 90s and wear a scrunchie. Zoom in on the scrunching, but as I said, I need to do like a find a full length mirror or something for you guys. Just at my first show of the day, Laura Biagliotti. It's so different from the London Fashion Week. It's like really a lot more sophisticated. Like, look at this, and like two balconies up, so many more people here. He thought I couldn't finish it. I think I did a pretty good job. I just don't like coasts. I'm just on the way back to the hotel because I desperately need a pair of trainers on my feet, killing me. But this is my outfit. If you haven't seen it already, head to toe. Yeah, head to toe tartan check with some epic heels with like pearls on them. They're really cute. From Koi Footwear. I love Koi Footwear. One of my favourite shoe brands.
I've been quiet inside you. Oh, all my heart in my chest shouts. Feeling silenced and lied to. But enough is enough. No,
don't confine me. I won't be here waiting.
Really handy. So if you want a cheap nice hotel, well, it's relatively cheap for Milan. If you want a nice cheap hotel in Milan, then where I'm staying, I'll link it below. It's actually, it's nice, it's okay. It's not like amazing, but it's like nice to be central. So my mission now is I've actually come out to get ice cream. It's so nice that it's warm at this time of night. I wish England was like, mission accomplished, guys. I found my ice cream. Really good.
Good morning, guys, for day two in Milan. I just wanted to do like a mini haul because I think I picked out some really cool pieces for this trip. So you would have seen the checked like tartan like two piece from Pretty Little Thing that was yesterday, but I wanted to show you in detail some of the outfits that I have this trip. So today I'm gonna get changed into this jumpsuit. It's got like one shoulder, but it's really cute and it's like just above the ankles, but I loved the way it sat. It reminded me of like very Vivian Westwood vibes around here. Next, I have this jumper from Pull & Bear. Like, tassels were so in London Fashion Week at, on the catwalk and in street style. So really a good trend for like autumn, winter and spring, summer. So we're loving a bit of tassels. This is from Pull & Bear, and Pull & Bear is one of my favorite places to get like jumpers and knitwear from, and it's super affordable, so definitely check them out. They have some great stuff. In fact, I might link a couple of my favorite things on there in the description box, because I really it's like a cheap Zara. Yeah, so winning. And then obviously we had yesterday's, which was the all-in-one tartan check. I don't know, but check is also gonna be huge, and it's huge autumn, winter, spring, summer, so like had to get full-on check. Check was bigger and better in like a whole new way, so I love the fact that I picked up all of, like, you know me, I have a trend, I do it like full out. And then on, I just have this gorgeous knit from like Runway, like one of the ones I showed you in a haul maybe last week, but really, really like affordable jumpers, but really nice knitwear, so definitely recommend checking out Runway for knitwear. Okay, day two in Milan, and I'm just gonna try and get up. I think you pronounce it the Duomo? Duomo? I don't know. But this is my outfit. The little bag from Runway, jumpsuit from ASOS, and my Nike shoes. The Nike shoes are part of the look, but I'm not going to my presentations from Milan Fashion Week till later, like 6 and 7. So I thought it'd be sensible and put flats on until later. So, oh my gosh, that queue's massive. Maybe pizza and wine instead might be on the cards.
So I thought it'd be a really good idea to take the stairs, not the lift.
Cars at least, and I really wish I had a photographer. Not want to like comment on architecture, but I'm pretty impressed.
It's a long way down.
It's so funny. I obviously don't have anyone with me on this trip, so I don't have anyone to take my photograph. But I just have absolutely no shame. Just asked about 6 random people to take my photo because they thought I have 6 pictures, one of them has to be good. So head on over to my Instagram and let me know if you like the pictures of the random people that took my pictures. So funny, when I first started vlogging, like I had
I was really nervous about like taking pictures in public or like talking to a camera, but now I have like no shame. Okay, just walking back to the hotel. I think I forgot to vlog those two shows, but I'll put some snippets or something here.
Location, let's focus on communicating, cause I just need the time and
place. I forgot to vlog, I told you I was about to vlog. I don't know if you can hear me because it's really loud, but yeah, I've learned several things about Milan. So firstly, Uber lies when they say a journey takes 19 minutes, it doesn't, it takes 5 minutes, which you can do in stiletto. Secondly, men are major pervy, like pervy times 100. And the women dress so well, like everyone's so sophisticatedly dressed, I love it. Definitely gonna take some Milan inspiration into my wardrobe. So I'm becoming a pro at eating out by myself. I came back to the same restaurant as yesterday and absolutely demolished pizza. I think I might be going back to Milan, back to the UK, literally it's stone heavier. I have jeans on right now that were loose and are now tight. But there are worse ways to spend a Monday. Yeah.